He's written it, directed it, stars in it, and it's a role that seems so demanding a regular human would require a year-long rest. Rishabh Shetty really, truly goes for broke. Hey all, my name is Sucharita. Welcome back to my channel. Do please subscribe to the channel or us bell icon ko press kijiye so you'll get first notification as soon as my reviews go up multiple times a week. Aaj we are talking about Rishabh Shetty ki Kannada movie Kantara, now in movie theaters. Rishabh Shetty is Shiva, a buffalo racing, alcohol drinking, loud and rowdy youth leader of sorts. When not participating in the sport of Kambala, he's also a strong man for hire and does odd jobs for the locals. I mean that. This relationship goes back centuries. Shiva is born into a tribal community closely linked with Zamindar's ancestors who were kings. The movie in fact starts in the 1800s when a king, unable to find peace, frankly your highness, same, goes into a forest and makes a pact with the tribals. Aap mujhe demigod panjurli do shanti ke liye, badle mein zameen par adhikar aapka. A voiceover narrates this story, and before I could roll my eyes at yet another voiceover, the film mercifully introduces us to a man telling the story to his daughter. Lo and behold, now we're in the 70s. A descendant of the king has tried to renege on the promise, he's gotten killed, and another voiceover has begun, cut to the 90s. Yet another man is continuing to tell the same folk tale to another as Shiva races his buffalo. One named Kapil, the other named Dev. Shiva को भी पता नहीं है, लेकिन ये generation से चली आ रही कहानी का नया central character वो है. This man has rejected tradition of being the Bhutakoda performer, लेकिन destiny तो destiny है. Kantara, which means mystic forest, is a marvelous achievement in storytelling. Through a forest officer, the writing explores our changing relationship with nature. Are natives in the wrong when they hunt wild game for sustenance? Is the law wrong trying to stop them to conserve dwindling wildlife? Does the forest not exist to grant the wishes of those dependent on it? But if you keep cutting trees, will a forest remain? Let's look at Officer Murali for a second. He represents the new hierarchy of a post-colonial power structure, a go-between the rich, powerful landlords and everyone else. A man who didn't exist when the story began in the 1800s. An institution created to uphold law and order, but as the cookie crumbles, is in the service of the rich and powerful, taking up space, relegating the have-nots to an even lower rung. So naturally, him and Shiva are enemies, but Kishore, who plays Murali, is also hesitant of the landlord offering him chai. Rarely do you get to see a government officer character actually treated with the inbuilt discomfiture of the job. Split in three directions, the landlord, Shiva, the forest, Murali, despite not being the protagonist, is the moral compass of the film. Protagonist is Rishabh Shetty in what I can safely say right now for me thus far has been performance of the year across languages. Shiva's journey from lout to the divine is a masterclass in character development, frankly, as is his acting performance. He manages to tell a story seemingly masala and mainstream, and just when you least expect it, subverts the whole damn thing. Bam! This is now magic realism. Bam! Now we're going to explore why humans created religion and how it's being weaponized by nefarious upper caste rich men. Bam! Now I'm possessed by the spirit Guliga, and now you have no idea where I'm taking you next. The man is a sensational performer who's written himself an incredible part. Shiva is not the traditional devout type. He eats meat, drinks alcohol, is very sexual, and yet, as is his fate, society ke norms about proper conduct destabilize ho jate hain like they should. I couldn't figure how many of his own stunts he does. I read he trained for months for the Kambala sequence. But here's a man fighting for his community's right to live with dignity, hand to hand, sword to sword, in kichar, in a forest, in slow motion. Each move is a nimble, light-footed, choreographed dance. And of course, there's choreographed dancing as well. You see, Rishabh Shetty also plays his own father, a Bhutakola dancer, and him with the face paint in the traditional outfit made of whatever the forest provides is a sight to behold. He dances as effortlessly as he shrieks as a part of his performance, his gaze and his sound searing through my whole body. Sitting in that packed auditorium, watching him unleash on screen felt like a visit to a holy site, as families upon families sat there transfixed, watching, absorbing, praying, forgetting to breathe. A dam is about to break, a man is about to revolt, a community is about to rebel, the forest secrets laid bare. While DOP Arvind S. Kashyap creates mystical, almost otherworldly visuals, rousing, dramatic, uplifting music by B. Ajanish Loknath adds to the trance-like experience of watching Kantara. Is the film perfect? No, it's too long, it meanders in the second half, and the love story between Shiva and Leela, played by Saptami Gowda, does not land. But is it a film I will recommend everyone go watch in Kannada before it leaves the theatres? Most certainly. I haven't seen a more rousing, a more meaningful climactic sequence in a minute. The movie perhaps is not for the faint-hearted due to some jump scares, but if you want to see a fascinating new way stories of gods can be filmically interpreted without punching down at other religions, constantly questioning the legitimacy of what one is conditioned to believe, Kantara is where it's at. Much like Mari Selvaraj's prodigious Tamil movie Karnan starring Dhanush, the images of Kantara, the faces and the bellows, the feeling of power soaring through your body on finally rising to a place of unbridled, unafraid, loud declaration will stay with me for a long time. So, on a scale of 1 to 10, Kantara is 15 crores ke budget par bani, if Wikipedia is to be believed, correct me if I'm wrong. Par ye film, Everything Everywhere All at Once, itne bade shining examples hain ki agar kaam aata hai aur mansha sahi hai, to lack of budget probably will not be the biggest hurdles. This is a good movie, bringing people to the theatres, watching it on Dashera in a nearly houseful PVR was poetic. मेरे हर्डल्स हटा दो रास्ते से, सब्सक्राइब कर लीजिए चैनल को, 75,000 क्रॉस हो जाए एक बार, देन आई विल आस्क फॉर 100, ये तो अनएंडिंग है. माय नेम इज सुचारिता, थैंक यू फॉर स्टॉपिंग बाय.